talking about Salome, it's such a sensuous role. Yeah. Was that something that came naturally to you?
No, it was like I was terrified of that whole part of it. I was so completely insecure, like, gosh, people are freaking out. I was completely insecure. The idea of the dance, the idea that playing this incredibly, like, this beautiful woman that people were in love with, I was like, what? I had a lot of problems accepting any of that. But I read this book that was really helpful called Sisters of Salome, and I started to learn, actually, that a woman's sexuality is a powerful thing, and we don't need to be afraid of it. And I think in some societies, when you are afraid of it, those aren't the best societies to live in. That actually kind of opened me up a lot, especially to the dance. But then also I saw the dance not as, like, a striptease or seduction. I know that's what it is, but for me, sometimes that's what it is. For me, I saw it as this girl's first sexual experience and as an act of violence, because it's murder. So I tried to make the dance as violent and as sometimes as ugly as possible, but yet keep along the lines of the Seven Veils. There was never like a nudity rider, or like it was never said I had to do nudity. I was always free to do whatever I wanted to do. But the more I started studying Salome and the actresses that have played Salome and the paintings of Salome, to me it became really apparent it had to be in a state of undress. This was through the Actors Studio, so the dance was never choreographed. There was always a musician on stage with me, and he would play, and I would dance, and the music would change depending on what I would do. The lengths of how long the dance lasted would depend, you know, vary depending on the night. So that was the scariest part for me, is like starting the dance and then going, I don't know how I'm going to get to the end of this when I'm disrobing, but I got to get there.